you were little, you had the funniest little stubby horns. Did it hurt when they started growing?
Damn things itched like crazy.
Another obstacle.
Do not waver!
You've crossed the wrong mongrel.
You should have listened to reason.
War.
Something? A failure is just a step to a success. A failure is just a step to a success.
I will not falter.
It went splendidly.
Can't hide from me.
This experiment has gone awry.
Our time has
come.
I do not believe this is possible.
Yes?
It went splendidly.
Now what is that?
Godspeed. Let us press on. Thank you. We march ahead. That is quite a discovery.
This experiment has gone awry.
A success worthy of praise!
Together we stand. Godspeed.
Let you hurt my friends. Yes?
Esme, Axe, yes.
Are we ready to move out?
Esme, Axe, yes.
What's on your mind? I wonder.
I stand ready.
Ama, so.
Save the last one for me.
Do not hold back. Strike as one.
Did I mess up again?
The world in crimson! This war must end. What's on your mind? I wonder.
Adayanon.
Do not fear! Do not waver!
Did I mess up again?
What is that?
Godspeed.
No reason to pause.
Magritium Turinos.
You're a good person. I like you.
Rely on me.
You are my favorite aide.
Yet another obstacle. Let us not hesitate.
Magritium Turinos.
I stand ready.
Are we in trouble yet?
You can trust me.
Are we ready to move out?
Trust in yourself.
They will break against our resolve.
The voice of the spirits.
Magritium Turinos.
We'll make things right.
Esme, Axel, Yasne.
Open your heart to me.
Magritium Turinos.
Magritium Turinos.
it went splendidly.
Greetings, valiant stranger who has just burst into my life. I am the master of this house, Count Daeron Kael, myriad mellifluous monikers Arundé. No need to introduce yourself. I find remembering insignificant details, such as the name of passing acquaintances, such a bore.
Wow. Bona fide blue bloods and unparalleled aristocracy. All this makes me itch to do something really crass. Ooh, like blow my nose on the curtains.
What are you waiting for, my squamous squire? The curtains in this room are velvet, but we have some excellent silk ones with gold thread elsewhere in the house. Take your pick. My soft furnishings are yours to do with as you wish. I'm quite sick of the place, truly. I shall either sell it or burn it to the ground and build a new mansion in its place. Now that we've finished with the niceties, tell me this. How did all those thrice-damned demons end up at my soiree? Canabras in ruins. Descari. Well, well, well. And I was already lamenting the lack of excitement at my little banquet. Although it must have been tolerable enough if we didn't get notice of a great hulking demon attacking a dragon just outside the window. It seems as though Descari's occasion was altogether more of a crush than mine, if you will pardon the pun. As a child, I had my very own pony, but I always dreamed of having a lamb. I was never allowed one. Sheep were seen as peasant animals, utterly unsuitable for the scion of a noble line. The trauma haunts me to this day. I think of it every time I have roast lamb for dinner.
I'm sorry that happened to you. Such a sad story.
I had not even the slightest intention of upsetting such a lovely child.
I'm not lovely. Some people have even called me a scarecrow before.
That's patently absurd. Why, you can't possibly be a scarecrow with a crow following you around. I'm sorry if I failed to sate your curiosity. I loathe talking about myself to people I don't know, even more to those I do know. The only thing worth knowing, aside from the fact that I am highborn and filthy rich, is that I dislike Puritans and demons in equal measure. Well, perhaps demons a tad more. I have no friends here whose untimely demise I would care to mourn. The only alarming thing is how easily all this happened. I don't care for the thought that demons could come calling at my door at any moment. And just think, everyone had so much faith in the wardstones gifted by Iomedae's herald, and in the might of our tamed dragon. As if there had been no Drezin or a dozen other routes where the demons overcame every defense.
The Arendes are one of the most ancient and noble families in Mendiv. They are related by blood to Queen Galfrey herself. The Count is the last remaining member of his dynasty. The rest all perished around 10 years ago, in the tragedy at the family seat, Heaven's Edge. The demons got past the defenses and massacred everyone inside.
I thank you for providing your friend with that helpful summary, my lady. I believe I've seen you before, with that hilarious buffoon Horgus Gwyrm. I sincerely hope you are not engaged in any kind of sordid arrangement with him. The thought of something so splendid in proximity to something so grotesque makes me feel quite ill. You deserve a better fate than that, no doubt.
Your civility knows no bounds, Count. I most assuredly do not have any arrangement with Master Gwyrm.
Of course, where are my manners? There. You can also poke about the house and claim whatever takes your fancy. Though I imagine some of you already had that in mind. I thank you for the invitation, but I am not quite as desperate as I may seem. At times, it is better to be surrounded by the repugnant mugs of demons than the sour and dour physiognomies of Iomedae's righteous paladins.
What about my physiognomy? Sour enough for his lordship? Don't worry, another few minutes with the dazzling count here, and it'll sour like week-old milk.
What's this? An attractive paladin with a sense of humor? You're a veritable walking scandal. Either way, my mansion is now safe. I have a pair of half-decent guards. I just need to drag them out of the storeroom and bring them to their senses. I ordered them to drink a love potion, you see? For reasons which seemed extremely witty at the time and in the state of inebriation I then found myself in. They can guard the house while the valorous paladins beat back the demon assault. They will beat them back, yes? As regards myself, I feel like stretching my legs. I know rudimentary divine spells, I am no friend to demons, and I elevate any society that I deign to grace with my presence. I shall accompany you, only for a short time, of course. I have no desire to remain at the vanguard for a protracted period. What say you, my ephemeral but highly diverting acquaintance? After all, Lord Descari spoiled my party. I now burn with the desire to spoil his. Capital. Good acquaintances that begin and end at just the right moment often leave the most pleasant memories. Would